Do not doubt the U.S.-Japan alliance. Tokyo's warning to North Korea ahead of Trump visit. Deputy Chief Cabinet Secretary Yasutoshi Nishimura told reporters that Trump and Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe agreed to work together to counter North Korea's nuclear and missile programs in order to reduce tensions in the region. In a 20-minute phone call, the two leaders agreed the schedule for the U.S. president's trip and confirmed they would remain in close contact over the North Korea tensions. Trump told Abe he is looking forward to his visit to Japan, that Japan and America are 100% together and there is no room to doubt the Japan-U.S. alliance, Nishimura said. He added, they agreed to deepen their discussions on the North Korean situation and other matters. Trump is set to arrive in Tokyo on Sunday for a 3-day visit before he continues on to South Korea, the Philippines, China and Vietnam. The president will be entertained by Pico Taro, the fake mustached singer behind the Pineapple Apple Pen hit, while also enjoying a round of golf with Mr. Abe and the world's number 4 golfer Hideki Matsuyama. He is also expected to meet the emperor as well as the parents of Megumi Yokata, who was kidnapped by North Korean agents in 1977 while she was walking home from school at just 13 years old. Japan's relations with North Korea have grown increasingly tense in recent months after Pyongyang fired 2 missiles over the country. Sirens sounded and Japanese residents received text alerts warning them to take shelter as the missile passed over Hokkaido last month. Mr. Abe responded, "We could never tolerate that North Korea trampled on the international community's strong, united resolve toward peace that has been shown in UN resolutions and went ahead again with this outrageous act." The recent launch also demonstrated North Korea's ability to strike the U.S. territory of Guam. President Trump has been embroiled in an exchange of insults and threats with North Korea for several months, recently goading Kim Jong-un, who he has nicknamed Rocket Man, by threatening to totally destroy the hermit country if it threatens the U.S. or its allies. Last week, North Korea claimed it is now a fully fledged nuclear power in a mysterious letter to Australia. Australian Foreign Minister Julie Bishop revealed she had received a letter from the Kim regime in which North Korea insists it will not be brought to its knees by President Trump's repeated nuclear threats. Addressed to the parliaments of different countries, the letter condemns Trump's speech at the UN where he boasted the US could totally destroy North Korea before announcing his rogue state had joined the world's nuclear club. The letter reads, "If Trump thinks that he would bring the DPRK, North Korea, a nuclear power, to its knees through nuclear war threat, it will be a big miscalculation and an expression of ignorance." The DPRK has emerged a fully fledged nuclear power